Please welcome lifelong heartthrob, Rob Lowe. Yeah.
Dog, he's so cute.
I know, that's Chunky. He used to sit still and now he just roams and knocks shit over.
No, he's in the background of every close-up of you. He's like, you just see him crossing. It's hilarious.
I know, it's good to see you.
Good to see you.
You got a lot of attention. First of all, I want to talk to you about that roast because
dogs love me, but incidentally, dogs and kids.
What?
I don't know what it says about me, but I think it's good.
What, dogs don't like certain people?
Yeah!
Like who?
Certain people.
That's actually true, you know?
Right?
My dog actually doesn't usually like men.
Just saying, we gotta...
You got a thing going with dogs? It's just not that unusual to be liked by a dog, is what I'm saying. Like, that's not something you bring up in a conversation.
Oh, I do, I bring it up.
So I wanna ask you about your roast. How do you just one decide to do that roast? Because it's brutal.
Brutal.
Those are, do you, are you-
You guys, anybody see my Comedy Central roast?
Yeah.
Brutal, right? Thank you. I have two-
what do you have, a fucking bone in your pocket?
I'm telling you.
What is going on?
I warned you. I mean, really, come on now. So I asked my kids, what's fucking happening?
Chuck, sit down and behave yourself.
I know, it's hard. It is.
Hope you're proud of yourself.
So I asked my kids are 22 and like 24 and they know everything that's cool. And I was like, should I do this roast? They're like, oh, Dad, you have to. I'm like, oh, all right. And then I asked my wife and she's like, you must not. And then she's like, well, wait a minute, are they paying you? I'm like, yeah. She goes, how much are they paying you? And I told her, she goes, oh, you have to. So it was both commercial and, you know, I love a good mean joke. I do. It makes me a bad person. I love
joke. I don't think it makes you a bad person. It's just subjecting yourself to, like, you're really getting, you know, raked over the coals.
The first, like, couple of times, you're like, ah, and then, like, the eighth time, you're like, ugh.
And then Ann Coulter, I mean, that was a disaster.
Listen, I think Ann thought we were serving roast. I just think it was an honest mistake.
She wasn't an honest mistake. She got paid to. She knows why she was going there. You can't never have heard of a Comedy Central roast and know what that means.
Exactly. Because, I mean, I asked a ton of my friends to be on the dais and most of them were too scared.
Yeah.
Or were like, I don't want to be mean to you.
Right.
I'm like,
yeah.
No, you got to be mean to me. That's the whole point of the thing.
Did you feel bad at all, though, when people were, I mean, they were like calling her the C word. I mean, it was pretty intense. Did you feel bad or you just, I mean, I don't really.
Here's the thing. I honestly don't think she got hammered that much worse than anybody else, but she definitely didn't seem to like it. I couldn't look at her. I didn't want, because on the breaks, people were coming up to me going, I don't think Ann's happy. I don't think Ann's happy. And I was like, bummed for her. And I was sitting next to Peyton Manning, and I was like, I can't look at her. And he says, brother, you can't look at her. You got a peripheral vision, that shit. It's like me staring down. It's like me staring down a safety, you know, the defense. You know, I just kind of peripheral everything, because otherwise, you know, I'm going to get hammered by it. You know, you don't want to get in it. It was like the best advice I'd ever heard.
So let's talk about your show. You've been on like 75,000 shows.
I just keep running, baby.
You are, I mean, it's like you, I was just talking to my girlfriends back in the makeup station because I was talking about St. Elmo's Fire. Because you still, I know you're probably so sick of hearing that, but it's like we all grew up with you and you're still here.
Right?
So like, I mean, are you annoyed by constantly being referred to as a heartthrob and people talking about your looks all the time?
Listen,
as a man?
When I was in my 20s and 30s, it was like, I'm so much more than that. And now that I'm fucking in my fucking 50s, I'm like, yeah, keep talking about it. Yeah. Yeah.
Right, totally.
All right, look, the older I get, the happier I am to be completely objectified.
That's interesting. It's an interesting cycle. It's totally true. I mean, women feel exactly the same way. It's like, don't stare at my boobs, don't stare at my looks. And then you're like, give me my boobs back, give me my looks back.
No. It's like the thing actresses go through. No, I don't do nude scenes. I don't do nude scenes. I'm 40 years old. Here are my tits.
Oh.
That's literally what they do.
since you got to the end of that video, I'm gonna show you something that's going to blow your mind. I realize that I've never walked up this staircase on my set, and I don't know what's behind this door at the top, so we're just gonna find out together. And
hey guys, hit the subscribe button right now for more videos.